from a camera on the truss of the International Space Station, a good view of Mark Vande Hei on the left, Scott Tingle on the right. Tingle in the first spacewalk of his career. The International Space Station has passed into an orbital sunrise, flying 251 statute miles in an orbit inclined 51.6 degrees to either side of the equator. The station is currently moving from northwest to southeast over the southeastern Pacific Ocean, soon to cross the west coast of South America. The work being conducted right now by Vande Hei and Tingle, right outside of the Quest airlock, is the releasing of a series of so-called EDFs, the acronym for expandable diameter fasteners. These are devices that provide structural rigidity between the latching end effector and the wrist of the Canadarm2 robotic arm to which the Lee is attached.
Here comes your right. All right, let it go. Thank you.
This is Mission Control Houston, 2 hours, 11 minutes into the spacewalk. All of the preparatory activities for the spare latching end effector residing on a spare parts platform on the International Space Station right outside the Quest airlock are complete. Next up for Vande Hei and Tingle will be the removal of the degraded latching end effector from the wrist portion of Canadarm2, sometimes affectionately known as Mr. Roboto.
The starboard APFR, the one in WIF 4, and Maker, the one in WIF 6. Reminder, only one crew member may ingress or egress APFRs on ESP2 at a time.
Okay. Let's begin. Your safety tether is on. It's going to pass your left knee. Up in front, though, right? It's going around the front and then in back. And it looks like it would go, if you move your feet forward, out backwards. What I was thinking is you might want to get it on. There you go. Move your feet backwards. Now, I'll move your feet forward again. Can you see where your safety tether is?
Yeah, I see it. I'm trying to get it on the other side, but
yeah.
It'll be working.
All right, we'll go with it. We'll
just keep an eye on it.
Yep. Couldn't go anywhere complicated. There you go. Pull your feet back now. Back, and your safety tether's in the place you want it. Right foot's in deep. That's good. Because you're about to get your heel in. Heel's in.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right. All right.
Before I get the left heel in yet, did you?
Nope. Working on it. All right, there it is.
Oh. I think you had no bent things, sir. And I've got good clearance with the arm.
Copy, and we got a great WVS view of that. Thank you. Verify clearance to the SSRMS wrist cluster, and you can rotate the Lee 180 degrees so that the EDF bolts point toward your feet.
That should work. All right, now let me get my local.
Man, that looked better than the Doug animation.
Let me get a good position. I'm going to work on the seam. What's better for me, over here or over on the other side?
I would recommend.
Really, you got a.
You could go station aft, and there's the CLA scoop back there to help you if you need to do some fine-tuning of the position over the EDF rings.
Kind of back where I was, by the crew lock bag.
The International Space Station flying over the South Atlantic, beginning a southwest to northeasterly track that will carry the complex and its crew members across the west coast of Africa a short time from now.
And gents, just a heads up on what's coming next once the arm is powered up. You're going to take the comm with NEMO and maneuver to published, and that'll be about an 80-degree negative roll on the lee. And we want to make sure that EV2 has access to EDF-6 and EDF number 3 for SABO. And if you look, station port, you can see the coast of Africa.
The International Space Station is about to cross directly over Lagos, Nigeria, and will continue to move from southwest to northeast over Niger, Libya, and across the northern coast of Africa over the Mediterranean. We are now 5 hours, 21 minutes into the spacewalk as the crew continues to tightly secure the spare latching end effector to the B side of the Canadarm2 robotic arm. This is Mission Control Houston at the 6.5 hour mark in today's spacewalk. Mark Vande Hei and Scott Tingle are beginning the early portion of the process to gather tools and tethers to take inventory of their equipment now that they've completed the installation of a spare latching end effector at the end of Canadarm2. The new end effector is communicating in great shape with the rest of the arm. All is well, and the crew has completed all of its tasks that were on the plate for today's spacewalk, the first of two such spacewalks associated with the refurbishment of this arm. The second will take place next Monday when Vande Hei ventures back outside, but this time with Norishige Kanai of the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency to bring a failed latching end effector removed from Canadarm2 last October into the Quest airlock. It will be returned to Earth on a subsequent flight of a SpaceX Dragon cargo craft, and to move the degraded latching end effector that was removed earlier today from the end of the arm to a attachment bracket on the mobile base system rail car of the station.
Copy. Yep, that's it. And the quarter turn fasteners are on the zenith part of the pivot bracket. Yep, I see you got one. And you don't have to make this pretty, gents. Get it ready to the outside of the bag, and you can head toward the airlock.
All right, my head hook is attached and black on black with a good pull test. Copy. All right.
Copy.
If
that's
you're
a good.
I'm going to go ahead and.
Copy. That's a good. Go ahead, table.
Release your. If you agree, I'm going to release Maker's safety tether and put my waist tether onto his safety tether. If you want to hand me the crew lock bag and I'll throw it in? Sure. That's a much better idea. I like the way you're thinking.
Maker, this is Joe on one. Just keep an eye on that rack going to the RMCT. It's going to get wrapped up on your right arm.
Okay, sounds good. Let me pop it off my BRT quick. Yeah, let me get a red on it. Hold on. Try to present you the side with the available spot. Okay.